ci mettiamo in ascolto dello Spirito Santo.
Invoking the guidance of the Holy Spirit, Pope Francis opens a landmark sex abuse summit on abuse, calling for concrete action. Good evening from Washington, D.C., and thank you to those of you joining us from around the world for news from a Catholic perspective. I'm Lauren Ashborough. Pope Francis opened a high-stakes, four-day clergy sex abuse summit by demanding action from bishops. He gave them a list of 21 reflection points to consider and discuss. He made it clear he expected concrete and effective measures. Bishops listened to recordings of five victims of clergy sexual abuse from five continents as they described their suffering.
Ci vuole concretezza.
And the Holy Father pleaded with 190 participants from bishops' conferences and religious orders around the world to listen to the cry of victims and to turn an evil into a chance for purification and understanding. Alan Holdren is our EWTN Rome Bureau Chief. Alan, what tone did the Pope's message this morning set for this summit?
Well, Lauren, he followed up those words imploring the bishops to concrete action with something very concrete, reflection points. He gave them 21 points to discuss and reflect upon during these discussions, including very practical things like making a handbook for how to deal with key moments in the investigation of accusations of abuse. Also, the establishment of provisions to include lay experts in investigations. These are things that we've heard about repeatedly, people calling for them over the last year. We also heard from people who participated inside the meeting hall who said that the atmosphere was one of intensity. The bishops really looking to get their hands into this and talk about it and come to concrete proposals for change. And also we heard from two of the organizing committee members who spoke about how the bishops really need to take ownership. They use that word ownership of these situations, of these problems, and also take responsibility for the healing of victims.
Is there any word on whether or not at the end of this meeting there will be concrete action taken?
Well, that's the hope. What they said today is that following up on those 21 reflection points, they won't be able to discuss all of them throughout these just 3 days and a half of meetings. So what there will have to be afterwards is a continuation, ongoing discussions about what to do. That's why on the tail end of this these 3.5 days of meetings, next Monday there's going to be a meeting between all of the different heads of the dicasteries, the different departments of the Holy See, and the organizing committee members will be present to speak about where to go from here.
Are you talking to the presidents of the bishops' conferences who are there from all over the world? And if so, what are they saying?
Well, there were a couple of bishops there present at a briefing that was organized by the committee for this meeting on the protection of minors. Archbishop Shikluna, who we continue to talk about as he's a part of the organizational committee as well, and also Archbishop Mark Coleridge of Brisbane in Australia. They were speaking about the real importance of getting together, coming together, and talking about these issues to come up with those concrete proposals for change. They said that this morning, a very important moment was when they heard five testimonies from victims. They just heard audio. The victims were anonymous, and they could hear the voices of these people describing the situations that they had lived, and they each said that that was a very powerful experience and that you can't walk away from that not being changed.
We heard from four victims yesterday here on News Nightly. We'll hear from some others in the coming days. Thank you so much. Alan Holdren, our EWTN Rome Bureau Chief.
Thank you, Lauren.